Do you sell merchandise for cash to your clients? Well, then you should know how to record that in QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. When customers pay immediately for products we sell them, the correct document to give them is a sales receipt. Selling items makes the quantity decrease and decreases the inventory asset for the purchase cost of the goods that were given to the customer. It increases the sales income account for the amount that the customers pay. For example, let's imagine on January 5th of 2020, we sold 20 apples cash today to Alan. All cash sales are directly deposited into the bank account at the moment we make the sale. So what would the price of the sale be? Well, 20 apples that we sell at $50 each means that Alan has to give us $1,000. And what did we pay for the apples that we just gave to Alan? Well, $10 each for 20 apples means the cost of the apples that were sold is $200. Now, this is what the trial balance looks like before that sale. But if we earned $1,000 in sales income, that means that sales will show up for the first time as $1,000. And because the cost of the goods that were sold in that sale were $200, for that very same sale receipt, cost of goods sold will show up in the trial balance for the first time as $200. And because we gave $200 worth of merchandise, or merchandise that we paid $200 for, since that went out, that means that inventory asset will decrease by $200 and become $3,200. And of course, because Alan gave us $1,000 cash, we have $1,000 less negative in our balance, and it goes down from $3,300 negative to $2,300 negative. And these will be the numbers in the trial balance after we record this sale. We go to the top left and click New, and we go down to Sales Receipt. The date is January 5th of 2020. The customer is Alan Arby. Now, the product or service in this case is apples, and we are selling 20 of them, and that means he has to pay us $1,000. Now, this is really sale receipt. Well, leave it as sale receipt number 3. It doesn't really matter. And notice the money is deposited directly into the Cash and Chase Bank. So it's very easy to fill out a sale receipt when you get paid immediately for merchandise that you're selling. When we click Save and Close, you can see that the numbers in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected and exactly as what we predicted at the moment that we recorded this sale receipt. Cost of goods sold $200, sales, or the sales product income $1,000, and then of course inventory asset went down to $3,300. Now, let's understand why inventory asset is $3,300. Click Reports, then click Inventory Valuation Detail, and you can see at the bottom of the Apple section, this January 5th sale receipt decreased the quantity of apples from 50 on hand, decreased by 20, and that's why the cost of the sale was 200. And now we only have 130 apples left in inventory. Let's take a look at the next example. Let's imagine on January 6th, 2020, we sold 20 bananas cash today to Betty. Well, all cash sales are directly deposited. The price of this sale, can you guess? Well, it's 20 bananas and we sell them for $100 each, so that's $2,000. And what's the cost of this sale? Well, we bought the bananas for $20 each and we're selling 20 of them, so that's $400. And those will be the numbers that change the trial balance when we record that sale. Okay, so that's January 6th, bananas to Betty. So we click in the top, click in the top left, sale receipt, January 6th, Betty, the product is bananas, and we're selling 20. That means she has to give us $2,000. After we click Save and Close, we should click Reports, Trial Balance, and you can see that sales has increased to $3,000 and cost of goods sold has increased to $600. Let's go over to the $3,000 and double click. And you can see both sales have been recorded in the sales income account, sales of product income. And you can see the first sale made it show up for $1,000. And then this second sale receipt on this second line here, you can see the January 6th sale receipt to Betty, you can see increased the sales income by $2,000 because that was the amount of sales income we earned, and that's why it's $3,000. If you click Reports and go back to the trial balance and click on the $600 for cost of goods sold, you can see, Reports, Trial Balance. Make sure you click on the $600 for cost of goods sold. You can see the very same sales receipts are recorded in cost of goods sold for the same dates and same customers. But if it's in the cost of goods sold account, it's showing the amount that we paid for the items, not the amount the customer paid, because we're looking at these sale receipts in cost of goods sold. So the second sale receipt increased the cost of goods sold by $400. Click Reports, click Trial Balance. So if cost of goods sold went up by $400, that means inventory asset decreased by $400 for the amount of this sale. Double click. Now you can see, if you double click inventory, the number, and go down to the very last transaction in the inventory account, January 6th, the sale to Betty has decreased the inventory account by $400 because that was the cost of goods sold. So now the balance of the inventory account is $2,900. And if you want to know the details of the balance of the inventory account, you click Reports, you click Inventory Valuation Detail. Now look at the bananas. You can see that this sale receipt on January 6th decreased the quantity of bananas by 20 and therefore decreased the value by $400. So we now have remaining $1,300 worth of apples because we have 130 apples. We have 80 bananas left that we paid $1,600 for. And when you add up the purchase cost of apples plus bananas, that's what explains in the trial balance the inventory asset balance of $2,900.